Today I am back with another video on aliens and the Area 51, and hope you guys who are interested in these aliens and conspiracy theories must be knowing about Area 51. It's one of the famous spots, military spot ground of in US, and today I'll be reading out an article on this Area 51. So the Area 51 has been the most focal point of alien conspiracy theories in America for decades. The remote military base in the Nevada desert has a lot of history and has been associated with aliens almost since its inception. In 1954, President Eisenhower authorized the development of a top secret high altitude recon aircraft program. It required a remote location that wasn't easily accessible to civilians or spies, and Area 51 fit that bill perfectly. In the early 1950s, US planes were conducting low-flying recon missions over the USSR, but there were constant worries of them being spotted and shot down. So in 1951, President Eisenhower authorized the development of a top-secret high-altitude recon aircraft dubbed Project Aquatone, and the program required a remote location that wasn't easily accessible to the civilians or spies. Area 51 fit that bill perfectly. It was in the Nevada desert near a salt lake called Groom Lake. No one knows exactly why it's called the Area 51, but one theory suggests it came from its proximity to the Nevada nuclear test sites. The Nevada test site was divided into a number designated areas by the Atomic Energy Commission. The location was already familiar territory for the military, as it had separated a World War II aerial gunnery range. In summer of 1955, sightings of UFO were reported around Area 51. That's because the Air Force had begun its testing of U-2 aircraft. The U-2 can fly more than higher than 60,000 feet. At the time, normal airliners were flying in the range of 10,000 to 20,000 feet range, while military aircraft topped out around 40,000 feet. So if a pilot spotted the tiny speck that was U-2 high above it, they would have no idea what is what, and they usually let an air traffic control know someone was out there, what led to the increase of UFO sightings in the area. While Air Force officials knew that UFO sightings were U-2 tests, they couldn't really tell that the public. So they explained the aircraft sightings by saying that they were natural phenomena and high altitude weather research. The testing of the U-2 ended in the late 1950s, but Area 51 has continued to serve as a testing ground of many aircraft, including F-117A, A-12 and Tacit II. No one knows for sure what Area 51 is up to these days. The government never even publicly acknowledged the existence of the base until 2013, while the release of declassified CIA reports. But if you are ever at the Las Vegas airport, keep an eye out for some small unmarked passenger planes in the fenced off area, and they are how Area 51 employees get to work from their home in Vegas. So this was an article which showed the connection between the Area 51 and the alien conspiracy theories. Actually, this Area 51 became popular among all the alien believers because in US this is the only one spot which is which observed to be the highest US spottings, UFO spottings. And also the Roswell crash, which occurred in 1947 in this Roswell, Mexico. That was also one incident that happened here, which further confirmed the existence of aliens. So this is still uncertain and are considered to be the conspiracies. So hope you guys like this video who are interested in aliens and all these kind of mysteries. And some more videos I will be uploading on aliens and this conspiracy theory. So keep connected with us and like our video and subscribe to our channel for more such videos. Thank you.